So today I will discuss two things in this first part. One is the subtractive cancellation, and then I will talk about multiplicative error, right? So first of all, let me define that what is subtractive cancellation. So and in subtractive cancellation, significant figures play a very important role, right? So, and all of you are familiar with the significant figures. If not, then go to your physics book of plus one, and then you will go through that, right? So let us define that what is subtractive cancellation. So let me define it is as loss of significant digits during a floating point computation, is known as subtractive cancellation, right? Floating point means, floating point representation means it's a representation of real numbers. Real numbers, and if we talk in terms of C language, so C language mein hum jab bhi real number ko define karna, I think float will be used, right? So it's known as subtractive cancellation. So let us try to understand that how there is a loss of significant digits when we do subtraction, right? So consider two numbers of almost equal magnitude. Jinka hum difference lenge, wo dono numbers kaise hone chahiye? Almost equal magnitude ke. So consider two numbers of similar magnitude. Means they're slightly different with one another. This is not very large difference. So let me call one number as 1.2345678 × 10⁵. And another number is 1.2345663 × 10⁵. This is another number, right? And how many significant digits are there? And these numbers are written in scientific notation. And how many significant figures are there? 8 significant figures are there. How many? 8. So 8 significant figures are there. And similarly here, 8 significant figures are there. And let me take their difference. If I take their difference, then its difference will be 1.5 × 10⁻¹, because now I am writing it in again in scientific notation. Scientific notation mein likha dobara se isko, right? So ye aa gaya. Ab jab maine isko subtract kiya, that before subtraction both numbers have 8 significant figures. What when I subtracted these two numbers, and after subtraction, what I am getting? I am getting that the result will consist of two significant figures. It consists of two significant figures, right? So how many significant figures? These are the significant figures. So two significant figures are there. So that means what? What does it mean? It means when I subtracted two digits of almost same size, then there is a loss of some significant digits, that and this is known as subtractive cancellation, right? बट द थिंग विच वी आर गेटिंग जो एक्सपोनेंट आ रहा था दैट इज ऑफ स्मॉलर साइज, ये इफेक्ट आ रहा था, लॉस हो रहा था और एक्सपोनेंट जो था दैट मे बी ऑफ स्मॉलर साइज. सो दस subtraction of two numbers of similar magnitude gives a result that might have smaller exponent. And another thing is that ant loses significant digits. And this is known as subtractive cancellation. And let us see its effect on computation, that how things will change sometimes. So let us take an example of x square and x square minus y square. So x square minus y square. If we want to calculate this x square minus y square, then what we will do, and numbers are written in floating point form or in the real representation, if numbers are written in that manner, then rather than writing this, we will always prefer that this computation can be done with the help of this, not using this, right? So we will prefer this rather than this. In real life both seems identical, there is no difference जो भी हमने asked, but when we want to do computation on computer, then we will prefer out of these two that this is more preferable. Let us understand it with the help of example. So 3.4457, there is one number, and let me take it square minus 3.4467. They're almost very close numbers, right? And it contains five significant figures. It also contains five significant figures. If I do simple multiplication, then what was the result? If I do simple calculation, then what was the result? Its actual answer kya aayega? Its actual value will be what? Its actual value is 6.8924 × 10⁻³. ये हमारे पास इसका actual result आता. It is its actual answer. But if I multiply these two, so then what it comes out to be, and it comes out to be, it will be equal to 11.87284849, and its value will be 11.87947409. And after doing this, but मुझे क्या करना है, I have to restrict myself up to the five digits, right? सो मैं इसको क्या करूंगा, लेट मी राइट डाउन इट एज 1.18728484 9 × 10⁻¹⁰ क्या हो जाएगा, इट विल बी माइनस वन. एंड सिमिलरली दिस कैन बी रिटन एज 11 not 11 but 1.18749474089 × 10⁻¹⁰ −1. ठीक है. एंड अप टू फोर डेसिमल प्लेसेस, सॉरी अप टू फाइव डेसिमल प्लेसेस, इट दिस नंबर कैन बी रिटन इन दिस वे एंड दिस नंबर कैन बी रिटन इन दिस वे, अप टू फाइव डेसिमल प्लेसेस, सॉरी फाइव सिग्नस. सो इट इज 1872 एंड इट इज 1.1879. एंड इफ आई टेक देयर डिफरेंस, देन दिस डिफरेंस इज नथिंग बट इट इज इट्स इक्वल टू −0.0007. ये रिजल्ट आ रहा था इंटू 10⁻¹⁰ नॉट सॉरी इट्स प्लस वन नॉट माइनस वन, प्लस वन आएगा ना. हाँ ठीक है. सो इट इज प्लस वन. सो इट कैन बी रिटन एज वॉट, इट इज नियरली इक्वल टू 7.0 × 10⁻¹⁰ क्या आ जाएगा, −7.0 × 10⁻¹⁰ कितना आ जाएगा, ये −2 यही आएगा ना, नहीं −3 आएगा, इट्स −3. सो इट इज द रिजल्ट विच आई एम गेटिंग इफ आई एम डायरेक्टली यूजिंग दिस फॉर्मूला. बट बिकॉज आई हैव टू टेक केयर द सिग्निफिकेंट डिजिट्स ऑल्सो, ठीक है. बट अगर मैं इसको देखूं देन व्हाट्स गोइंग ऑन, सो इट इज 3.4457 − 3.4467, दिस इनटू 3.4457 + 3.4467, ये मेरे पास रिजल्ट आ रहा था. सो इसको सब्ट्रैक्ट करेंगे तो क्या आएगा, इट इज −0.0010, ठीक है. एंड व्हेन दीज टू गेट्स एडेड देन इट इज 6.8924. सो इट मीन्स −6.8924 × 10⁻³ −3. सो नाउ सी, ये आया इस फॉर्मूले का यूज करके, और यहां पे मैंने किस चीज का यूज किया, आई यूज्ड दिस फॉर्मूला. तो सी द डिफरेंस, यहां पे भी सब्ट्रैक्टिव कैंसिलेशन हो रही थी, यहां पे भी सब्ट्रैक्टिव कैंसिलेशन हो रही है, बट बेटर रिजल्ट्स कौन सा आया, ये वाला आ रहा था, ठीक है. सो दैट्स व्हाई दिस सब्ट्रैक्टिव कैंसिलेशन इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. एंड व्हेन वी ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट द रूट्स ऑफ क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन, वहां पे भी सब्ट्रैक्टिव कैंसिलेशन का काफी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल रहता है, ठीक है. सो दैट्स व्हाई इन कंप्यूटेशन वी विल प्रेफर टू यूज दिस फॉर्मूला रादर देन डूइंग कंप्यूटेशन यूजिंग दिस फॉर्मूला. ठीक है. इफ समटाइम्स रिजल्ट गेट्स बैड देन यू कैन इम्प्रूव थिंग्स, ठीक है. सो ये छोटी छोटी चीजें, दैट्स हाउ टू एलिमिनेट द एरर इन कंप्यूटर्स. देन लेट अस टॉक अबाउट मल्टीप्लिकेटिव एरर. नाउ लेट अस टॉक अबाउट मल्टीप्लिकेटिव एरर. Multiplicative error. So errors in computer multiplication कैसे आता है, मतलब that what will happen, how things will change. So इसको हम generalize करेंगे. Okay. So let x t and y t are the two values of something. Right? These are the two values. And let XA and YA are the approximate values. And if these are approximate values, then that means there is some error. And what was the error? Let me call EA and EB are the errors in X and Y. So that means how multiplication XT into YT can be written as, it is XA plus error in A into YA into error in Y. Not EA and EB. Okay, so let me call it as EB. XA, YA. Okay. EX and EY. And let me call it as EX and EY. That will be better. Sorry, and plus is there. This is plus. So let me simplify it. So if I open this, then it is XA, YA plus YA. EX plus XA, XA, EY plus EX and EY. Since error is very small, error may be in the fourth decimal place or the fifth decimal place, and error in X is also in the fourth or the fifth decimal place, and error in Y will also be in the fourth or the fifth. So, and when those gets multiplied, then let me talk about this part basically. Say error in X is, let us assume that 001, and error in Y is also 0.001. Let us imagine. Then their product will be 0.000001. So that means, keeping these things in mind, then this term can be neglected. Clear? Why I am neglecting? That's why I am neglecting. This is a very, very small number. When a number less than 1 gets multiplied, that will become more smaller. And when two numbers greater than 1 gets multiplied, it will become more and more. And sometimes we think when numbers get multiplied, they always keep on increasing. But when the numbers are less than 1, then their product will always become smaller than those individual numbers. So it means this is equal to this one, right? And this is XAYA. And let me take XA and YA common. It means it is EX over XA and EY over YA. It's a little algebra you can do. So that means this is the total error in the product. Because XT and YT can be written as XAYA into error in XY. So that means this is that term. So that means EXY is known as XAYA EX over XA plus EY over YA. Right? So this is the multiplicative error we can calculate. Right? So that's all for this part, and in the next part I will talk about error propagation in in the next part I will talk about errors and their estimation, means how errors propagate, right?